So very good afternoon to all of you. So today we are going to solve a hydrostatic force concept problem in the 10 minutes of trick. So this is the problem to us. So a curved surface LM, which is in the form of a quadrant of a circle and it is having a radius of 3 meters is given and which is immersed inside this water. Okay, this is the water surface and this curved surface, this is curved surface LM and this curved surface which is immersed inside this water. Okay, and it is the width is given you as unity. If you see the perpendicular to the screen, the width is given you as this is 1 meter. So it is asking, we have to find out what is the horizontal component of the hydrostatic force and what is the vertical component of the hydrostatic force. Okay, and this depth is given you as 1 meter. Okay, from the free surface to this point M, end point this one, starting of this curved surface, and the last point, this is the last. And this is given you as 3 meter. Okay, so let's proceed this one. So in order to find out the horizontal component of the hydrostatic force, we have to choose a vertical plane and we have to project the end points of the curve onto this vertical plane. Suppose this one is my vertical planes and I am projecting this end point. So this is the L to this one and suppose this one is L dash. Similarly, I am projecting this point M onto this vertical plane. So this is M dash. Okay. So now if you see the side view, if you see the side view of this one, the projected surface of the curved one, it will looks like a vertical planar surface. Okay. So in order to find out this horizontal component of the hydrostatic force, we have to go the same procedure which already have followed in vertical planar surface. So what is the thing? The horizontal component of the hydrostatic force, that will be equal to density of the water into g into yc into this area. You have to take the projected area. Projected means this one, the projected area of this curve one. Okay, so this width is you given you, this is unity, and this height is given you, this one is 3 meter. Okay, this one is 3 meter and this height is how much? This is 1 meter. Okay, so very simple. So let's start this one. So horizontal component of the hydrostatic force, that will be equal to density of the water into g into the centroid. Centroid of the projected planar surface. Okay, projected planar surface into the projected area. Projected planar surface area. So what is this yc? Yc will be how much? So yc will be, see, this is the free surface. Okay, this is my free surface and this is my centroid. This is my centroid. So this distance will be, so this distance, this will be yc. Okay, this distance will be yc. So yc will be how much? This yc will be, this is 1 meter is given you. So this is 1 meter plus the centroid will be how much? This is 3 meter by 2. Okay, 3 by 2. So this is 2.5 meter. What is the projected area? The projected area is how much? This is the projected, this is w into this 3 meter, and w is how much? So this is 1 meter, the unit width. Okay, so this is 1 into this is 3, so this is 3 meter square. Okay, so now this yc, I already found out this is 1 plus this is 3 by 2, so this is 2.5 meter. What is the projected area? What is the projected area? That is w into 3, w into h, that is 1 into this is 3, so this is 3 meter square. So what is the horizontal component of the hydrostatic force? Horizontal component of the hydrostatic force will be density of the water into g into this yc into this projected area. So this is how much? Density of the water, this is 1000 kg per meter cube. This is 9.81 meter per second square. Into this yc is 2.5 meter and this projected area is 3 meter square. Okay, so you have to convert into kilonewton, so divided by this one is 1000. If you do, this is coming out to be 73.57 kilonewton. So this is the magnitude of the horizontal component of the hydrostatic force. Okay, so now you already found out the magnitude, but we need to find out the location where it will act. Okay, so where it will act means, suppose this is the point, this is the point where the your hydrostatic force will act. This point is called as center of pressure. Okay, now in order to extend, if you extend this line, So line of this action of the force, so we can find out where it will act. So here it is the horizontal component of the hydrostatic force will act. Okay, so we have to find out this location. This is YCP. We need to find out this location. Okay, YCP. So very simple. So YCP will be equal to, this is YCP will be equal to, this is YC plus the moment of inertia about the centroid divided by this is area, projected area into this YC. So everything we have to take care of the projected area. Okay, so moment of inertia, which was, so this is my already the projected area. Okay, this is projected area and this is 3 meter is given to you and this is my 1 meter. Okay, so you need to find out the moment of inertia about the centroid. The centroid, what is the moment of inertia? This is 2.5 plus this is b into this is hq divided by this is 12. So b hq by 12 divided by this projected, this is 1 into this is 3 into this is 2.5. So if you solve the center of pressure where the horizontal component of the hydrostatic force is acting, that is coming out to be 2.80 meter. Okay, this is the position where this horizontal component of the hydrostatic force will act. So now we have to find out the vertical component of the hydrostatic force. Vertical component of the hydrostatic force. So I already discussed with you, in order to find out the horizontal component of hydrostatic force, we have to take a horizontal plane. Okay, and we have to project that point, and everything we have to calculate based upon the vertical planar surface. Similarly, in order to find out the vertical component of the hydrostatic force, we have to project the end points of the curve on a horizontal plane. So this one is my horizontal plane, the green one, blue one. Okay, this one is my horizontal plane. Okay, and this horizontal plane, we have to project this end point. Suppose this point is L, I project this point on this plane. So this is my L double dash I projected. And similarly, this is, suppose this point is my M point, and I projected this point on this one. So this is M dash. Okay, now we have to, the area I have to choose, the area enclosed by this entire thing. Okay, this added, you start from this L, you move on to this one in this direction, and you will find an enclosed area. So you have to find out what is the weight of the water or weight of the fluid contained inside this enclosed area or contained inside this shaded area. So that will be equal to the magnitude of the vertical component of the hydrostatic force. Where it will act? It will act at the centroid of the shaded area. Okay, suppose I am choosing, this is my surface 1 and this is my one second surface. Okay, so let's proceed this one. So the vertical component of the hydrostatic force will be equal to, this is weight of water. So this is weight of water contained, weight of water contained inside the shaded area. Inside this shaded area, what is this shaded area? That is L M M double dash L double dash. This is shaded area. So what of the water will be mass of the water into g. So I can say this is density of the water into the volume of the shaded area. Okay, volume of the shaded area into g. So density of the water into volume, I can add, this is area of the shaded area, area of the shaded zone into the width, the perpendicular to the screen. Okay, so into this g. Okay, so this is density of the water. Area of the shaded area is separated or divided into 2 1. So this is area 1 plus this is area 2 into this is w into this is g. Okay, so now what is this area? Area 1, you see this is the 1. If you find out this area A1, what is this area A1? So this is 1 meter is given to us. Okay, and the radius is, this is 3 meter. Okay, this radius is 3 meter. So area will be, this is 1 into 3. So this is 3 meter square. Similar, A2 is how much? If you find out this A2 is how much? A2, this is the quadrant of a circle. This is the first quadrant of a circle. So this is pi r square by 4. Okay. So pi, radius is 3, or the 3 square by this is 4. Okay, so now, so this is, you can write down, this is density of the water into area 1 is how much? This is 3 into this is 1 plus this is pi
into this is 3 square by this is 4 and this width is 1 and this is 9.81. So the density of the water, this is 1000. Okay, so this is 3 plus this is pi 3 square by this is 4 into this is 9.81. so in order to convert into kilonewton, we have to divide it by this is into 1000. Okay, so if you divide by 1000, this vertical component of the hydrostatic force, that is coming out to be 98.77 kilonewton. Okay, kilonewton, this is the vertical component of the hydrostatic force. So where it will act? It will act at the centroid of the shaded area. Okay, this vertical component, shaded area. Okay, so now suppose this is my chord surface. Okay, suppose this is my chord surface, this is my chord surface. You will find out this is the horizontal component of the hydrostatic force. Okay, and this is the vertical component of the hydrostatic force. So in order to find out the resultant, this is my resultant. So in order to find out the resultant, when the resultant component of the hydrostatic force, that is what? The resultant component of the hydrostatic force at the square root of this horizontal component of the hydrostatic force square plus vertical component of the hydrostatic force square. Okay, so that is how much, if you solve this one. So let's, I'm solving here. So this is square root of horizontal component is how much? This is 73.57 square plus this is 98.77 square. If you find out the resultant component of the hydrostatic force which act on this chord surface, that is coming out to be 123.16 kilonewton. So this is the resultant force which act on the chord surface. So now this is my horizontal component of the hydrostatic force. Okay, and this is my vertical component. If you extend this line of action, so here it will act my resultant component of the hydrostatic force. Okay, so thank you. I hope you understood the concept. If you feel any doubt in this concept, please intimate with me and ask your doubt. So you can take my contact number. This is 9556407657. This is my WhatsApp number also. You can put the doubt in this WhatsApp so I can clear it. So thank you. Have a good day.